Here I have sukuma wiki, which is kales, which are planted in February. Using future, you know, February in this area is a dry season, so I have to use a future pump so that I could develop this farm. Now the way you look at it, it is now a rainy season, so it cannot do well, but it was so nice when it was dry season. And during dry season, the demand of kales is high because there's that scarcity. So when the demand is high, the supply is down, and then I sell kales at a high price. So that's exactly what I did. I got some reasonable money from this small acreage of kales. I also did maize during the same season, and now I'm harvesting this maize. This maize is almost, I've harvested three times, already it is getting finished. Maybe before the end of the next 3 or 4 days, I'll be done with maize. So now that people are expecting a harvest, we have already harvested. So that's the challenge. I'm harvesting as green maize when the green maize is not there in the market. So I'm also selling at a very high price. In fact, at one cob, I sell at 10 shillings. So these maize were planted about 2,000 stems at 10 shillings. That's definitely 20,000 from this less than an acre, almost a quarter of an acre. But if you go to the, if you sell in terms of dry maize, that would be 40 shillings per 2 kg tin. A 2 kg tin will be 10 cobs. So me, I sell green maize. 10 cobs are at 100 shillings, and when it is dry, 10 cobs are 40 shillings. The difference of 6 shillings is what we are losing. So with the future pump, or when we plant during dry season, the demand is high, the market is there, and then we get money that can take us a step higher. So the future pump has really made us have to challenge the weather, so to say. There's something